Halo teman-teman, salam jumpa lagi di channel Aleman Busel, panduan latihan bahasa Inggris atau didak. Saya agak bosan-bosan nih teman-teman, selalu saya menyampaikan ini. Jadi bacaan ini didukung standar SPOK, verbal non-verbal, sama tenses. Inilah pedoman, pegangan, ya, panduan, nah, supaya bisa ngobrol ini. Jadi bagi teman-teman yang baru aja menyimak, ini panduannya ini teman-teman. Sekarang kebetulan ngobrol, judulnya maksudnya ngobrol keseharian pakai kalimat bahasa Inggris standar, keren banget. Langsung kita ini nih, topiknya formally girlfriend. Ya, jadi biasa saya baca dulu. Lemon has just arrived in main office and meeting Bush. Hi Lemon, welcome here again. Have you just arrived? No. Before going up to second floor, I stopped by the cafeteria for a drink. Suddenly, I saw my formerly girlfriend in there. Did you? Well, I think you have just had a planning first. No, I have never got the planning to meet her, Bush. Wow, what happened then? To be honest, Bush, this happening was just coincidence. I got caught there, and I really came to have a glass of drink. Once again, it was coincidence to happen with us. Oh, I see. When both of you met in there, how she reacted at that time, Lemon? I thought that she was a great surprise as well by seeing me in there. He was really caught by seeing both of you in there. Yes, bro, but I said nothing. Even she addressed me first. So, did you spontaneously welcome her greeting? Hi, Rinda. How do you do, Rinda? I replied her greeting. Her name is Rinda. In short, what happened then? You know, Bush, secondly, she made me a hot news. Okay, once again. You know, Bush, secondly, she made me a hot news. That she had given me a small sheet of paper after talking for a minute. Of course, I didn't expect it at all. Well done. So you have pawned her, haven't you? No, I didn't want to take a good chance, Bush. It looked exciting, however. It's just a Fata Morgana or mirage. Then you have made a decision, I mean that not making to be bad situation on your daily life. That's right, good point, Bush. How about something which you have accepting from her? All right, bro, now I will show you something. Would you please tear up and throw it in the trash? Here it is. Again and again. Amazing, bro. Indeed, I salute you. Without looking at the sheet of paper, he immediately tore it off. All right, bro. I have just thrown it into the rubbish box. Now, would you please follow me? We're going to be in a meeting room. Yes, we are going to have the last meeting, okay? But first, thank you so much for supporting me, Bush. You're welcome, bro. Oh, I see. Yeah. Oh, ini indah nih, teman-teman. Oke ya, jadi saya itu bacanya tadi bisa diulang-ulang, teman-teman. Oke. Jadi jangan lagi berdebat masalah pronunciation. Ya. Itu aja, udah cukup lumayan lah. Bisa ditiru gitu. Formerly girlfriend, mantan pacar kan gini. Lemon has just arrived in main office and meeting Bush. Jesse Lemon baru saja tiba di kantor pusat dan ketemu sama Bush. Ini present perfect nih. Artinya di sini waktunya nggak jelas nih. Jadi sudah baru saja tuh. Jadi intinya kalau menggunakan present perfect tuh ada kata sudah atau telah. Tapi nggak pakai keterangan waktu itu present perfect namanya. Lemon just arrived tuh kan in main office and meeting Bush. Gampangnya gini, teman-teman sering dengerin aja, dengerin lagi gitu. Okay, yeah. Hi, Lemon. Welcome here again. Have you just arrived? Hey, datang lagi. Ya, baru nyampe nih. Gitu. Lo baru sampe ya? Gitu. Oh, kalau di sini, hey, Lemon, selamat datang ya. Kita ketemu lagi di sini. Baru sampe ya, gitu. Baru. No, before going up to the second floor, I stopped it by the cafeteria for drink. Suddenly, I saw my formerly girlfriend. Past ten. Dia nanyanya present perfect tuh. Di sini present ten, di sini past present perfect, di sini past ten. Coba begini ngomong bahasa Inggris kan, di sini ada past ten before going up to the second floor tuh. Ini soalnya jiran bisa di sini. Before going up to the second floor maksudnya sebelumnya gua ke lantai 2 dulu, ya, berhenti mampir di kafe gitu. Tapi dia gua ngeliat mantan pacar gua gitu, mantan gua ngeliat mantan sama mantan gitu. Did you? Well, I think you haven't just were planning, boss. Masa sih, kenapa dia pakai beat sama teman masa. Ya, did you? Dari sini dia acuannya ini, I stop it untuk dua ini. Did you? Masa sih, bahasa Indonesia gitu. Masa. Well, I think you have just had a planning first though. Kembali lagi dia ke pesan berpok. Dia gak pakai ini, pakai pesan berpok aja dia. Disini pasti. Ah, gue pikir sih, paling lo punya rencana dulu gitu. Dia punya rencana dulu gitu maksudnya. Ya gak apa-apa, namanya juga ngobrol. No, I have never got a planning to meet her, bos. Gak pernah gue punya rencana ketemu sama dia gitu, bos. Gak pernah. Wow, what happened then? Apa yang terjadi tadi tuh maksudnya? To be honest, bos, this happening was just coincidence. I got caught there and I really came to have a glass of drink. Once again, it was a coincidence to happen with us. Jujur aja, bos, dia bilang. Terjemahnya, kejadian itu mendadak, bos. Ini mendadak nih. Ya, kejadian itu mendadak. Saya kepergok di situ, kepergok dan saya, gua benar-benar minum kok, mau minum gitu, aus gua bilang gitu. Itu kejadian itu nggak direncanain tuh, itu was coincidence tuh. Dia memohon itu betul-betul kejadian mendadak gitu sebenarnya. Ya kepergok gitu, nggak disangka gitu. To happen with us tuh dua-duanya. Oh I see, oh gitu. When both of you met in there, how she reacted at the time? Dia nanya ke pasien lagi. Oh gitu. Ya dia diterima loh gitu, alasannya. Tuh ketemu lo berdua di situ reaksi dia gimana? Pakai pasien. How she reacted at that time waktu itu, waktu tadi maksudnya gitu. I thought that she was a great surprise as well by seeing me in there. Gue pikir sih dia juga terkejut juga gitu, kaget juga dia, surprise soalnya dia kaget juga gitu. It was really caused by seeing both of you there, itu artinya lo kepergok berdua-duaan gitu. Iya betul. Yes bro, but I said nothing, even she dresses me bro. Tapi gue gak bilang apa-apa kok bro, justru dia yang negur gue duluan. Wah, si dresses nih menegur nih, but I said nothing bro. Tapi gue gak bilang apa-apa, bahkan dia yang berdua gitu. So did you spend anniversary welcome for greeting? Tapi lo spontan dong, nyambut apa, salam dia. Ya, hey Rinda, how do you do Rinda? I replied her again. Ya, apa kabar Rinda? Gitu. I replied her greeting tuh. Oh namanya Rinda. Terus singkatnya, what happened then? Apa yang terjadi tuh? What happened it then tuh? Pasten terus ini. Meskipun tadi dari atas ke bawah cuma belum ada berapa jam kan gitu. Belum paling juga 15-10 menit tuh. Nah inilah ngomong teman-teman. Syarat ngomongnya begini pas then. And you know bos, secondly she made me a short news. Hot news sorry. Lu tau gak bos, yang kedua dia membuat aku juga berita apa, kabar panas juga nih gitu. Kabar ya cukup mengagetkan juga lah gitu. Shock gitu. That she had given me a small sheet of paper. After talking for a minute, of course I didn't expect it at all. Setelah basa-basi itu, katanya dia ngasih selembar kertas kecil gitu. Kan kejutan tuh. She had given, nah ini pas perfect. that she had given me, gak usah dibahas ya, ini beda nih. She had given me a small, ini terjadi di past tense. She had given me a small sheet paper. After talking a minute, ya udah, sebenarnya sih gue gak mengharap apa-apa gitu. I didn't expect it at all, itu bahasanya. Oh, well done, keren. So you have phone her, haven't you? Kalau gitu udah nelpon dia dong. No, I didn't want to take a good chance. No, I didn't want to take a good chance, Bruce. It looked exciting, however. It's just Fata Morgana or Mirage. Ya enggak lah, gitu maksudnya. Gue enggak mau ngambil kesempatan ini. Gitu. Kesempatan dalam kesempitan, kesempitan dalam kesempatan. Kelihatannya menarik, tapi ya seperti Fata Morgana itu kelihatannya kan. Ya kan? Ya ada kesempatan. Fata Morgana kan tahu sendiri, dari jauh mengagumkan, udah dilakukan kayak berantakan gitu. Then you have made a decision, I mean that not making to be bad situation in your daily life. Kemudian lo juga udah ngambil keputusan ya, maksud gue tuh lo udah gak mau mengubah situasi yang dalam kehidupan yang sekarang yang udah nyaman kan gitu. That's a good point, Bos. Nah, itulah poinnya lo. That's a good point, Bos. Ya dong, keren dong ngomong begini. Then you have made a decision, I mean that not making to be bad situation on your daily life. Coba lihat teman, ulang-ulang lagi gitu. Gitu. Terus dia nanya lagi, how about something which you had accepted from her? So, gimana yang dikasihin sama dia tadi? Gitu. Alright bro, now I will show you ya. Something would you please tear up and throw it in there in the trash. Here it is. Kalau ngasih begini, here it is, satu. Kalau dua, here they are, gitu. Oh baik deh, gue nih gue kasih nih. Sekarang gue kasih tahu nih. Ya, lo bakar deh, lo sobek-sobek, lo masukin ke buang tempat sampah. Ini lo ini gitu. Gitu orang ngomong bahasa Inggris. Alright bro, now I will show you something. Would you please tear up nih, tear up di sobek, buang di sampah. Gitu. Dibakar bisa. Jadi sobek-sobek maksudnya tear up ini. Gitu. Dan buanglah di tempat sampah. Here it is, ini. Again and again, amazing bro, keren lo bro. Gue salut lah sebenernya. Tanpa melihat ya, dia kan gue sambung gitu. Wajar kan, tapi ngeliat langsung disobek-sobek. He immediately turn it off bro. Ya masukin di tempat sampah. Di robek hancur nih. Hancur. I've just thrown it, gue buang di tempat sampah bro. Inbox. Now, would you please follow me? We're gonna be in the meeting room. Ya, sekarang lo ikutin gue deh. Ada pertemuan yang terakhir nih. Oh iya. Yes, we are going to have the last meeting, okay? Kita memang mengadakan meeting yang terakhir. But first, thank you so much for supporting me, Gus. Tapi makasih ya dukungannya, Gus. Iya. You're like, makasih kembali. Gitu, teman-teman. Keren kan ngomong begini, ya kan? Ulang lagi, baca lagi gitu. Nah, sekarang saya bahas sedikit tuh tensisnya tuh. Ya kan, tensisnya beragam tuh ngomong. Empat tensis ini, pedomannya kepake semua. Jadi di kalimat ini ada present perfect, ada present tense, ada past tense, ya ada verbal, ya kan, kalau merah begini tuh, ini ada non-verbal. Gitu ngomong bahasa Inggris. Ya cuma ini, pedoman. Jadi di dalam bacaan ini, ada semua ini. Tuh. Standar, ini kan standar SPOK semua. Ya inilah bahasa Inggris internasional, teman-teman. Jangan ragu-ragu lagi, ulang lagi, dengerin lagi. Oke ya? Gitu. Nah sekarang saya akan coba lagi nih. Tapi sampai sini dulu deh teman-teman, kepanjangan nanti. Ya diulang-ulang lagi aja. Oke. Jadi gak usah lagi dengerin katanya gini-gini katanya lagi. Udah sekarang lupainlah masa lalu, ya kan gitu ya. Oke teman-teman, gak lupa saya terima kasih buat teman-teman yang udah subscribe. Yang belum ya terima kasih. Saya ikhlasnya juga ya, keikhlasannya gitu. Makasih teman-teman. Maaf kurang lebihnya. Assalamualaikum. Bye-bye.